Hey guys, welcome back to Sharing It. Google has launched the Android P's developer preview. So let's see what are the new things and how can you get Android P even if you don't have a Google Pixel device. I'm Ujjwal Tripathi, you're watching Sharing It. Looking at the GUI, you get a Google Pixel launcher with a search bar and a microphone bar. And you can clearly see the start and end of the dock. Earlier in the OEO, the settings tab was having a very dull look and now it's gone more brighter and more colorful. So you can see that Material Design 2 is here. I've also made a video about Material Design 2. You can check it out over here. In the notifications bar, all the buttons are rounded and you can see a blue color when they're on. And if I've noticed one thing, that clock has moved to the left corner. So Android is preparing for the notch for the upcoming devices. Maybe that's Google Pixel 3. New notifications for messages. Now you can reply to your messages from the notification bar, seeing like the reply app. The notification bar also shows the images and the messages too. So you can quickly reply over there. If you don't want any notifications from an application, you can hold on the notification bar and over there you will see two options: to discard it and to switch it off. Talking about the battery saver orange bar, yes. Now you will not see any orange bar if your battery is low, below 15%. In Android P, you also get an always on display, so you can double tap on your screen and your device is on. It also shows notifications. Earlier it was not in the OEO. The lock screen shows time and notifications with a dash between them. And there's always the Easter egg of Android P. When you touch down the Android P, you get an Android P logo over here, which you can see on your screen now. Coming to the best part that I've liked about the Android P, that's screenshot editor. I've mentioned it in another video that you can watch over here. Now when you take screenshot, you will see some tools to edit your screenshots. Same like Xiaomi screenshot editor or the WhatsApp screenshot editors. And the big relief is that you need not press three buttons to take screenshot, or now press the power key and you will see the screenshot option over there. Your Wi-Fi hotspot will be turned off when it's not in use, saving your battery life. Indoor positioning with Wi-Fi RGG. Accurate indoor positioning was a challenge for all the developers. Android P adds a new Wi-Fi protocol, that's 802.11mc. That's also known as Wi-Fi round time trip. Now Android P devices that will have the hardware support, they can locate nearby Wi-Fi devices and measure the distance between them. They need no need to be connected to these devices and you can easily measure the distance. Android is saying that the distance is accurate about 1 to 2 meters. The multi-camera API. Now you can simultaneously use your front cam and your rear camera, just like the Nokia phones. You also get an HDR VP9 and HEIF for image compression support. Now that's a bit technical stuff, so we'll see it later. Autofill improvements. To autofill any passwords for password managers, but now it's been improved and you can easily fill the passwords. Now the main question, how to get it? You can get it if you have a Pixel mobile, Pixel 2X or Pixel 1X, but you can't use it in your Nexus device. There's another option that you can download Android Studio 3.2 version. I've given the link in the description below, and install the emulator for the Android P and you're good to go. So guys, that's us in this video. Like this video, share this video and comment down below what do you think of Android P. Till then, see you in the next video.